are your specific proposals for raising revenue in the next 4 years?
So tax tolerance is low, and we can raise much more funds, many more funds, by focusing on economic development. And that's what makes this dark fiber lit San Leandro so important. You know, for every high-tech job, there's a cascading effect of 5 ancillary jobs. And that's what we need to focus on. But we need to make sure that we're bringing in the right high-tech companies. If we bring in data farms, they only have a handful of employees, and that's not going to help our economy. That's why it's so important that our city is out there actively courting places like Adobe and, gosh, all kinds, you know, Oracle, those kind of companies that have lots of employees. We can't just sit here and expect it to happen. We have to be out there selling San Leandro, selling the assets we have to offer, and making sure that we all benefit. You know, it's not just the companies that benefit, but as they succeed, our community succeeds as well. And so that's what I would focus on to increase revenue.
So for those of you who don't know, every time we have a property tax dollar collected in San Leandro, the city of San Leandro only receives 12 cents every dollar. That's not enough. Property tax is not bringing in revenue. Brings in revenue when people come and shop and live in San Leandro. We have a built-in city. That means that we have to figure out ways to promote transit-oriented development, more people living here, working here, and spending money here. During the time I've been on council, we finished Creekside Plaza, which has 1,000 employees. We're about to break ground on Village Marketplace, which gets people shopping. We've done more to improve the lighting in downtown to get people out of their houses and in the community, shopping, spending money in San Leandro. That's what we need to do.
What are your specific proposals for raising revenue in the next 4 years?
Got it. First and foremost, I'm going to fire our law firm that represents us. We'll save $5 million right off the top. Secondly, right after we do that, we're going to start with our perception problem, because truly that's the only problem we have, is that we've got this perception that San Leandro is a not a beautiful place, but it is. We have all the resources. We have all the dots, from our wonderful marina to our wonderful, sure, we can call it downtown. But we have key restaurants, which is not really downtown. I call that uptown, by the way. Downtown is downtown, okay. So thriving businesses, some of them touched on it. We do, we need San Leandro to be thriving. We want people living here, working here, being entertained here, and we want them to feel safe. And they are safe here. We just have a perception problem. We need to get out there and let folks know how beautiful and how amazing this town is and how friendly we are. We need to foster the small business, and we need to make sure that big business like Kaiser's not being given hundreds of thousands of dollars in breaks or possibly millions of dollars in breaks. With the corporate institutions need to be the ones paying, you know, and the small business guys and gals and homeowners, we need to be fostered. And anyway, the buzzer buzzed.